Hey guys, Myagi here, and I'm going to show you how to make a really thick detuned pad sound in Curve 2 using some subtle modulations and even some FM. Here's the sound we're going to go for, a nice pad sound full of motion and falling in and out of phase so it sounds really big and fat. Let's start with an initialization setup here by pressing New. I'm going to make wave 1 into a sawtooth wave using this analog style waveform selector over here, and then apply it to oscillators 1, 2, and 3. I'm also going to click on wave 2 and make it into a square wave, just so we can add some harmonic variation. I'm going to apply it to slot 2 in oscillator 2, and then blend the waves using this crossfade knob to give us a little bit of the square. Next up, I'm going to pitch oscillator 3 up 2 octaves and bring it up in the mix a little bit. This is just going to add some really nice extra high-end timbre to the sound. Next, I'm going to set up the filter section. I'm going to choose the LP12, so low-pass 12 dB filter, and the BP12, so band-pass 12 dB, for my filters, which will give me the ability to get some nice dramatic sounds here, as well as some subtle morphing. One of the nice things in Curve 2 is the ability to set up the filter routings per oscillator. By that I mean you can take any oscillator and route it to the filters in either series or parallel, depending on what you need. In this case, I'm going to put oscillators 1 and 2 in parallel mode, so that they get set to both the filters side by side, and oscillator 3 will go in series, first going through the low pass and then to the band pass. Now let's add some resonance and find some sweet spots. Nice. Okay, so that's a good starting point, but not super pad-like yet. Let's adjust the volume envelope to give us a nice long attack and release, more in line with what we're after. Rather than just a straight linear envelope, we can add our own edit points to make a gradual curve, which is one of the awesome aspects of the synth. Excellent. That's getting better. Now let's hit up the mod matrix. When we mouse over a mod slot, we can see that on certain mod slots that a 3-slot overlay shows up. This means that in these slots, we can apply certain modulations to the 3 oscillators in varying amounts. In this case, I'm going to apply envelope generator 2 to oscillator 2 a very, very small amount and have it affect the pitch. This will allow me to slightly detune the second oscillator using the second envelope generator. If you like detuning, this is a really powerful feature. Now let's add some mod points to the envelope generator 2 so that we get a nice flowing effect, and we'll take advantage of the looping aspect of this envelope as well. After the attack and decay phase, the envelope will loop this section over and over until release. So let's add some subtle mod points so that we can get a nice morphing flow. If we draw the loop out, we can hear the really cool aspect of this feature. One of the cool features of a looped envelope is that you can adjust the loop size so that it takes a shorter or longer time to complete its cycle. Sort of like a user-definable LFO shape. Let's add some FM. I'm going to hit up the mod matrix again and add some FM from oscillator 1 to oscillator 2, and a little bit from oscillator 2 to oscillator 3. This is just going to add a really nice harmonically complex tone to our sound. You can also experiment with using the envelopes to apply FM too. That's a really nice source of motion. Next up, let's hit up the macro section. I'm going to take the default macro 4, fatness, and bring it up to detune the sound more and give it some extra character. The fatness knob adds unisono voices, which are voices that play in parallel with slightly detuned pitches and scattered volume and pan settings. It really widens up the sound. Next up, I'm going to map macro 1 to control the filter cutoffs. The macros in Curve 2 allow you to assign multiple parameters to a single knob to allow for lots of really easy and creative expression. It's a very powerful feature. I'm going to apply macro 1 to control the second envelope going to filter 1's cutoff, and then add a little bit of the same macro to filter 2's cutoff in the inverse. And then I'm going to give them nice ranges that complement each other well. Let's try that out and listen to a couple filter sweeps. Now that's getting nice and lush. Just by tweaking out a few parameters, we can get a ton of different tones, and you can really hear how this type of sound will work in building up a track. Opening and closing the filter gives us drama and motion, and by using the looping envelopes and the macros, the possibilities are endless. So, thanks for checking this out. For more info on the amazing Curve 2, check out cableguys.de. Remember, this synth has an incredible, ever-growing library of presets submitted by amazing sound designers and other users. It's an incredibly inspiring instrument.